Let's talk about the Tennessee Titans. Now, this week, Ryan Tannehill stepped away from the game with an injury, and the Tennessee Titans have not been playing well this season. They haven't been able to get the running game going. Defense has been okay. It's been holding them down. But for the most part, the Titans have been lackluster. We've already discussed the possibility of Rabel getting fired. But let me ask this question. With the injury to Tannehill, do you think the Tennessee Titans should do what they should have done last year and start second-round pick Will Levis for the remaining of the season? Dante, I'll start off with you.
I mean, I'm not a big fan of either one, but I'm definitely not a fan of Malik Willis. And it's a tough situation because you got three quarterbacks that, oh, brother, they all stink. And I was a Ryan Tannehill defender for the longest time. But at this point in time, you just got to call bygones, you know, at this point. Malik Willis is not ready. He's never been ready in college. I told you he was a bum at Liberty. He couldn't stick around at Auburn. He got punked by Bo Nix and the nepotism that they thought was going on there. And he went to a lesser school and started winning big games. But as soon as he played Matt Corral Ole Miss, everybody just wanted to ignore that he was just a mid quarterback. Then gets to the combine and he's helping homeless people out. Then the narrative gets changed again because he's a nice guy. I'm tired of all this, man. What does this have to do with him playing quarterback? That's great that he's a good community guy, but this doesn't translate onto the field. Oh, great that he could throw very long bombs down the field. Can we all sit here up and say who's the last person? It was actually in this draft. Who hit the ceiling at the facility during their pro day?
Anthony Richardson.
I'm not saying that I'd take AR over Malik Willis every day of the week. Like, I'm not comparing the two. But at this point in time, from what I see from Will Levis in college, and if you could take his ego down, he does have arm talent, man. Nobody can deny that. The kid does have arm talent. The kid is gutsy. He'll run the ball up the middle and get you yards. Like, I mean, if you want somebody that's going to dig under and now is the third string on the depth chart and wants to work his way up, stick him in there and see what he can do. I mean, I'm not opposed to it, but the best thing that the Tennessee Titans did is they benched him, made him a third stringer, and told him, like, hey, you got to work for this. This could be one of those situations where Mike Vrabel might have a demon in the making. I'm not saying about from what I know about Will Levis that he's going to be a demon, but you never know, man. Pressure makes diamonds. And I'm not saying that that's going to be him. I'm just saying,
you're talking about the same Will Levis?
With all the talent that Will Levis has, it could be a good situation for them. Skip past Malik Willis. You know what you got. Go with Will Levis and see what you got with him. You're in the place where you guys are already performing better than what everybody expected in the National Football League. Yeah. I mean, all of us are surprised when they're beating teams like, what the hell? They beat them this week. They are doing okay. DeAndre Hopkins is getting more comfortable. Derrick Henry had a breakaway run. I think he's getting a little bit more comfortable this time of year now. So see what Malik Willis has got. See if those guys gel around each other. And it might be one of those things where it takes a village to build him up. I'm just trying to be optimistic. I know we killed the kid for a very long time, but I love situations where they take his ego and they check it at the door and they maybe try to develop this guy behind the scenes. So I'm optimistic. I mean, it's a great question. They should just move on to Will Levis. Just go ahead and stick him in there. We're in week 7 now. This is a perfect time.
Sora, let me ask you, Ryan Tannehill on the lower end in passer yards this year, he's on the lower third of passing yards. Is third tied for third in interceptions. We've seen Malik Willis in the past. We've seen Malik Willis last week. Nothing to write home about. Do you think it's time that the Tennessee Titans give Captain Mayonnaise a chance and let him start the rest of the season?
Captain Mayonnaise.
Again, same as what Dante said. I don't think either of these quarterbacks are good. This is where the Matt Corral needs to come in.
Unfortunately, Ryan Tannehill was their best one.
Yeah,
unfortunately. That's crazy.
They're dying on this Tannehill. I mean, we've seen what both these quarterbacks have looked like in college. Will Levis was constantly carried by Rodriguez and Wandale Robinson. Malik Willis was just he just ran a lot. Again, I will and Dante, I'm so glad you brought up that game with Matt Corral and Ole Miss. I remember sitting down on the couch. I was excited to watch that game, and I was like, this is who everybody's hyping up.
I was excited to be right, and I was.
People had the audacity to compare this dude to Donovan McNabb. What are we doing here?
People were going into that game saying Malik Willis is gonna be better than Matt Corral. It was blasphemous.
I know. I was like, I was sitting on the couch. I was ready. I was like, oh, I can't wait to see. What the hell am I seeing here?
Okay, we got to get off of Matt Corral. This became a Matt Corral show, unincidentally. So
nothing excited about it.
It's almost like he was a good quarterback in college and just hasn't got a fair shot yet.
Well, he got to get out of his own head, too. So.
That is also true. I'm still going to say no. Do not start Will Levis because, again, he is not technically, he is a rookie. Tannehill doesn't need both of his ankles to teach him what to do. Yes, you have a couple of wins. We're a little surprised at that, but y'all aren't really going that far. Earlier in the offseason, you're talking about trading Derrick Henry, and now those same rumors are heating back up during the trade deadline. You're using a lot more of Tajay Spears simply because of the fact that until last week, Henry's kind of been slowed down a little bit. So you're kind of just building pieces. It doesn't make sense to, if Will Levis is your guy, which I doubt it, but if he is, don't rush him out for a team that's tanking. Just keep Malik Willis in at that point. And maybe Malik Willis will surprise you or something. I don't know. But with the more use of Tajay Spears and other running backs like Hassan Haskins, Derrick Henry, I don't know if it will be a Titan after this year anymore. It could be next week he gets traded, or it could be after the offseason he's let go. But they have shown signs that this is a rebuild. And also, this QB class is quite deep.
We've been saying that before everybody else was saying it.
I know this would be the third year in a row you drafted a quarterback, but eventually you got to get one right, right?
I'll draft him in the second. Maybe you'll get it right.
Man. Like draft him in the first. You went from the set. You drafted one in the second, in the third. First of all, you traded one up for the second that was supposed to be a first round talent and fell out of the first round, which I called, by the way, just saying. And you traded up for the. No signs are going off of like, why did this dude drop out of the second round? If he was projected to be like a top 10, top 5 pick, people were saying he should have gone over guys like Anthony Richardson.
Man, they thought he was going to be the first overall pick. Yeah, who are we kidding ourselves?
He was the first overall. It's just.
Yeah. If he wasn't first, he was supposed to be second.
There were red flags all over the place. And this isn't even the coffee or banana joke. There's just. He has not been good. He was not that good in college. He couldn't even beat out Sean Clifford. And Sean Clifford's older is as old as a T-Rex. It's baffling.
I mean,
you can
make that argument about Sean Clifford and everything. I get it. Everybody always says that, but he was mad young too.
Didn't even beat out Sean Clifford, man.
I get it though. But he was mad young, like.
If I could just shed some light on that situation.
Go ahead.
Will Levis was a backup quarterback at the University of Penn State. Yes, he did get beat out by Clifford. But the issue is, we all know the way politics work at Penn State. Clifford was tenured. That was Clifford's position. They were going to give it to Levis no matter what. But I will say this about Will Levis. He does have a good arm. He is a very good arm talent. He can make all the throws. His only issue is decision-making. Like Sora said, when he was in Kentucky, he had two players, the running back and a wide receiver, that can, you know, take the pressure off. But I think in Tennessee, he still has that in Derrick Henry, in DeAndre Hopkins. You know, he has players that can step up and assist him if need be. Now, for Tennessee, I think, listen, we know what we did. We know what we have in Tannehill. It's not working. We know the mistake we have in Willis. It's not working. Let's put all our eggs in the basket, at least for this season, and let's see what we have in Will Levis. Let's open up the playbook and let's do things that's easy for him. Let's evolve this offense around Will Levis and what he can do, and then build off that. I think with Tajay Spears, with Derrick Henry, you have a good nucleus around him already. Again, he might mess up. He might have some mistakes here and there. But that's what, and that's what most rookies do. But the one thing is, he's been sitting back for 6 weeks. He's been learning. So it isn't like he's going to go out there raw. And, you know, I think that he will make some mistakes, but I think he could overcome it. He could probably have Tennessee, you know, question, should they get another quarterback? But they have to give him the opportunity. They have to give it to him now. Let's see what we have in Levis. Again, he's a big arm. He can get the ball downfield. You don't really need to do that with him. You can have him manage the game. Again, you have two good running backs and a capable wide receiver and a tight end. Mold the game around what Will Levis can do, and I guarantee you the Tennessee Titans will start winning games.
Yeah. I mean, they got nothing to lose. I mean, you drafted the guy, so you might as well start him. And then, I mean, the biggest scapegoat is this draft class, because I'm telling you right now, my prediction for this year's draft, this will be the most quarterbacks chosen ever in the history of the draft.
Not only that, I think there's going to be a lot of coaching turnover, too.